Well, welcome everyone around the globe. I'm Scott Clausen with PPM Works. I have an exciting topic to share with you today, how to use the new project roadmap. So just a few pointers. If you have questions throughout, I'm happy to take them. Go ahead and use the Q&A up in the Zoom, or I will stop at certain points and you're welcome to ask me questions verbally. With that, I'll go ahead and get started. So our agenda is pretty brief. We're gonna do some introductions. I'm gonna then kind of jump into the tool. Most of the time will be spent in demo, starting with the project home. And of course, we'll spend most of our time in roadmap and allow some time for question and answer. So again, my name is Scott Clausen with PPM Works. I've essentially been working with the Microsoft PPM project and portfolio management solution for over 20 years, starting way back with Project Central. My role is hands-on with customers, helping them initially implement Project Online, migrate Project Server up to Project Online, extend Project Online with Power BI reporting integration, so forth. And I'm always trying to keep up with the latest and greatest from Microsoft. And today is one of those sessions where I get to share with you what I've learned about Project Roadmap. So a little bit about PPM Works. So we are a gold certified Microsoft PPM partner. We really work hard for your results and satisfaction. Our team is very experienced, like myself. Many of us have been working since the initial release of Project Central over 20 years ago. And we worked across many different industries, whether it's bio, pharma, healthcare, manufacturing, et cetera. We provide some of your basic services that you would expect, training, whether that's PMI certified training for PMPs or just mini training courses on learning new technology like roadmap or resource engagement, some of the new features. Of course, we offer the professional services to help you implement Project Online, migrate to Project Online, any specialized solutions you would need for integrating, and of course, ongoing support, having the ability to answer your questions right away. So we have a few objectives today. I'm going to show you first how to enable a roadmap in your organization, provide you a full understanding of roadmap features and benefits, and of course, introduction to Azure boards, which are agile project management tools. So if you are a Office 365 admin in your organization, you may have received an email similar to this. This one I think I received 2 weeks ago from Microsoft. And it's essentially announcing what they call a major change notification. Don't need to be alarmed there. It's not gonna impact existing users, but it's announcing a big release of a feature. So what do we find in this email? I kind of highlighted a few things here for you. First of all, how does Microsoft describe roadmap? They describe it as a cross-functional big picture view of all projects underway, making work visible in one place. So as you've probably learned already with the Microsoft Office 365 suite of products, there's lots of different ways to manage projects. Many of us come from a background of using Project Server or Project Central, and that's one way. There's new lightweight ways to manage projects through tools like Planner. And then for particularly IT and sprint projects, there is a tool that used to be called Visual Studio Team Services, now called Azure DevOps. So what Roadmap's doing is helping you bring two of those, currently Project Online and Azure DevOps, into one place. So important note about impact, this is right from Microsoft's email, so it will not impact existing user experience. Users will, once it's enabled, see a new option to create roadmaps from Project Home, and I'll be showing you that today. And then a couple steps in the email about how to enable in your organization. You're gonna need to be an Office 365 admin or work with your Office 365 admin. And then you're gonna need some users, at least one, enabled for Project Online Premium or Project Online Professional. Okay, so with that, I'm actually gonna show you how to enable. So here I've signed into my Microsoft 365. And here I can go, for example, to my project admin. So let me just go there. So I'm moving now to my Office 365 admin portal. So this would be the part to enable roadmap in your organization where you would need to work with your Office 365 admin if you're not. And those Office 365 admins are going to be able to come into this home admin center, and they're going to go down here to settings, and they're going to click this option for services and add-ons. And here you're going to see a bunch of different services that your organization has licensed. And if you scroll down, you'll eventually find Project Online. So it's just interesting to note that the way to enable roadmap is found under Project Online. And here you'll see actually just one option where you want to turn roadmap on for your organization, which I've already done. So once you do that, it will then be enabled. And as I mentioned already, it will not impact existing users. Okay, so how do we go about using the roadmap feature once it's been enabled? One thing you want to do is go to Project Home. This Project Home was rolled out about 6 months ago, and I'll show you how to get there if you haven't. If not, there's a URL for you right there, project.microsoft.com. And what we'll do to kind of provide a full demonstration is in step one, we'll actually create a Project Online project. So you can do that from Project Home. If you haven't seen that already, I'll show you. Step two, we're going to create an Azure board project. This may be new to you if you haven't used Azure DevOps to create Azure board projects. So I'll show that. And then step three, we can bring it all together and create what's called a roadmap. So with that, let's go ahead and jump in. So as mentioned, if you are signed into Office 365, you can go to your application launcher here and you can find project. And when you click that, it's going to take you to your project home screen. Now, you can also put the URL that I had there, project.microsoft.com. Hopefully this home screen is not totally new to you. As I mentioned, it was rolled out about 6 months ago. And what we're gonna do to kind of give you the full story here is first start on this create new button, and we're gonna create a new project. And if you didn't know already, from this project home screen, you can create new projects. I click that. It's now going to transition me over to Project Online and ask me which type of project I want to create. Now, these are just the default options here, a SharePoint task list project or an enterprise project. In your organization, you may have Project Online configured already, so you might have different types of enterprise projects. So let's go ahead and use the enterprise project. We'll do next. And I'm going to call mine Project Liftoff. And it's going to start today. So I hit finish, and just in a few moments here, it's going to go ahead and create my project liftoff. And it's taking me again, this would be configured to how your environment is, but in this particular default environment, it takes me right into the schedule view of the project. So I'm just not going to take too much time here, but I'm going to have a planning phase. And under my planning phase, we're going to run a kickoff. We're going to have a project plan session. And then our planning will be complete. Now, by default, these are what are called manually scheduled tasks. Just for simplicity, I'm going to move them over to auto schedule. I'm going to indent a few of my tasks here. I'm going to put duration in as 10 days. And this will be my milestone at the end. And I'll go ahead and make these linked. So I see kind of what traditionally, I guess you would call a waterfall here. So I have this waterfall kind of layout of my project starting today, at least this phase finishing on the 25th. So go ahead and publish this now. And we're done, so we can close it. All right, so let's go now back to our project home. And in fact, if I refresh the screen now, hopefully I see my project liftoff lifted as, there it is. Project liftoff is here now. And just another note from project home, you can do things like create favorite projects. Just provides a way for you quickly to access them. Okay, so that was step one, creating our project online project. Let's do step two now, which is to create our Azure DevOps project. So different ways you can get here. Probably the easiest here is if you click this link here to go to dev.azure.com. And let me just bring it over here. dev.azure.com. All right, and once you're in Azure DevOps, you create something called an organization. And this organization I've created is PPMW Demo 1. Once you've done that, you're able to create what are called projects. So I'm gonna create a project here called Project Liftoff Agile. Now, when you're creating projects, there's some options here. I'm not gonna go into the full details of using Azure DevOps in this session, but I'm gonna go ahead and keep it as a private project. And if you look down here, there's different ways you can process your work items. The default is Agile, but there's other ones. In fact, I'm gonna choose this one, PPM Demo Agile, but there you can create your own. You can have CMMI or Scrum. Let's go ahead and create our project now. So I now have my Agile project here in Azure DevOps, and I'm gonna move, there's lots of different functionality here. We won't cover this all today. Code repositories, pipelines, test plans, artifacts. We're gonna be focusing on the boards area, which is kind of our Agile project management. And I'm gonna go right now to my sprints. And I wanna show you that by default, when you create a new Agile project, it's gonna have these different iterations. It's gonna have three iterations. So we're gonna give these iterations some dates. So our first one is actually going to start a little ways out, let's say March 4th, and run through the March 8th. And then we'll go on to our iteration 2, make sure that it has dates. It's going to pick up for us already where the last one stopped, at least it usually does. Yeah, the 11th through the 15th, that looks good. And then my iteration 3, which you could also rename if you prefer using sprint names. Start on the 18th and run through the 22nd. So I have three iterations or sprints here. And when I come into, for example, my backlog, it's saying that here are my iterations, it has some days, and I'm gonna add something called a user story through this button, add new work item. So user story, we're gonna do a sample one here. We're gonna need to, for our project liftoff, create a welcome screen. We add that. Next, we're gonna do another user story. And this user story is gonna be a profile screen. So I've added those two user stories, and I'm actually able to drag these into the particular sprints I have. Let's just do the first one in the first sprint, the second one in the second. Now, as I click these different sprints or iterations, I'm able to see my user stories there, welcome screen and profile screen. Last thing I'm gonna do kind of to show you this is go into the edit of this user story. And I've made sure I have some dates here. So this first one, kind of looking at my sprints here, is gonna be that week in March. So I'm just gonna put some dates in for this user story. Go, close it, And also for my second one here. Profile screen, similar thing. Let's just go ahead and put dates for this start and finish date. Okay, so what have I done? Just to recap, I have created my Agile DevOps project, defined some of my iterations, added some user stories, lots of other things you could do. You could come in here and add actual tasks to show status across this kind of what they call a task board type interface, lots of neat stuff. But we have the basics at least to show what we want to now for a roadmap. Okay, so next, I'm gonna go back to my project home. Again, that's kind of the starting place for everything. And just to note, even though you have created that Agile DevOps project, it doesn't yet appear here in your recent on the home screen. Maybe that's a nice enhancement that'll be coming down the way. But we're ready at this point because we have our project liftoff created in Project Online. We have our project liftoff Agile created in DevOps to kind of bring it all together in a roadmap. So just like when I created my project and Project Online from the home screen, I'm going to pull the create new button down and click roadmap. And here, that fast is able to create a roadmap. Now, just to note, when I first set up this environment, the first time I went to click create roadmap, it was about a 2-hour wait. So the very first roadmap you're going to create, expect a little bit of delay. My Microsoft set some stuff up. So this is going to be for project roadmap. So I created my, project liftoff. So I've created my roadmap from the home screen, and I've now given it a title. Next, you see kind of this timeline view here with the ability to do two things, add a row or add key dates. So let's go ahead and click add row. Here it's an untitled row, and you're able to define an owner for this role. So my account is domain admin, I'll use that. And then you have this option below here to connect to a project. Interesting, what's that? I pull it down and I see there's two different types of projects I can connect to. The first one I'd like to connect to is my Project Online project. So I'm gonna click that. It's gonna go ahead and connect to my Project Online environment and allow me to search for projects. So if I type project, I see project liftoff there. Next, it brings up this little section here talking about information about the project connection. And it mentions that members of this roadmap will have full access to connections in the created flow and the content within the connected account. So this is gonna do something behind the scenes that I'm gonna show. It's creating something called a Microsoft flow to get the information, in this case, from my Project Online project and bring it into roadmap. So this I already set up already. Basically, my login to roadmap is done. My login to Project Online is good. So I'm ready to connect to this project. And this is probably the hardest part in the whole process, which is once you're connected, you're able to select items in that project. And it's very picky. You notice if I type A, nothing's found, B, T, nothing's found at all. So you basically need to find a full name of your project. And I remember when I created my project, I had a whole phase in there called planning. So once I type planning, it's able to bring that planning phase in there. Remember that from the project plan, here's the dates. And then I know as well when I type planning, I also have a milestone in here for planning complete, or what they call a key date. So let's just start with those two items from my Project Online project and click add. And there we go. It was able to bring my phase in as well as my key date planning complete. But this, as we say, is just the first part of the picture. We want to bring in the rest of the information, which is coming from our Agile project. So we're going to kind of repeat what we just did there, starting with the add row. Here, I'm able to, again, define an owner, so it'd be me. Now, when I choose connect to a project, I'm going to choose this time the Azure boards. There's my liftoff project, connection information. If it didn't say connect, I'd have to adjust the sign in, it's ready. And a little bit like with project, the hardest part here again is finding those particular, in this case, user stories, but I started with the word user story. So I can type user and it finds my two user stories. Let's add one. Two and add them. So, but by the way, I didn't mention this, but as it connected, it renamed the particular rows and I was able to do, bring together, this is the idea of all in one place, my liftoff project with my agile project. And if you wanted to resort these, let's say, since kind of chronologically, it's gonna start with the traditional waterfall project, let's go ahead and move that up on the roadmap. Then we move into our agile portion where we're doing our user stories with those dates. Another great feature you have here is if you have a particular key date that you would like to add that doesn't fall exactly within one of these two projects. So I can do that with right next to the add row, I can add key date. And let's just put this as user stories. Wait, and we'll move that out a ways into March near the end. And that's gonna put my key date right up on the top here. So this is not in either one of those two projects, just one I've added here to my roadmap. Other features you have is ability to set the status on these items. This is also independent of what you have in your project. So if you click on one of these particular roadmap items, you notice at the bottom here, you're able to set status on track. This particular status might be at risk. This particular status might be already or high risk. And just to show you the full gamut here, we also have done. So you're able to set the status. Again, this is independent of anything in the project online project or as your board's project. It's just information that you provide status here in your roadmap. So I've set this up. I'm able now to go to members, share it with people in my organization if I want for them to see it. Once it's shared and they come to this project home screen here, just like I'm able to see this roadmap here and perhaps add it as a favorite, they can do the same and they can very quickly get back to this roadmap to see again, these key phases and the dates across the different types of projects. Another thing I find really helpful with this is the ability then to navigate to these items. You might come to this roadmap, you might be wondering, is that really when planning's complete? Let me find out more about that. I can click Open Details. That's gonna bring the details pane over here on the right, and I can open this connection here to planning complete. That was able to navigate me all the way to my project schedule and project online. Similar, if you want to go to your Azure board, again, open details, click the link there, and it'll take a user right into the, in this case, user story view for this work item. Very helpful. Another feature we have, if we happen to be here in find my project details again. If we happen to be here in our project details, notice even when you don't have the project checked out, I'm just viewing it here, but I do have permissions to roadmap. You can actually add from project online items to a roadmap this way. So I can find which roadmap, which row I wanna put this on, planning project plan session and add it. Now then I go back to my roadmap and refresh. Actually, it may take a while to sync. Let's see here. And there it is. I was able to add this. So what I'm showing is you can add items here from the roadmap by typing their name, finding a whole word, or you can add items right from your schedule in Project Online. I don't believe at this point there's a way to add items directly from Azure Boards, but I would imagine that's coming shortly. Very good. So just in review, what did we cover? Then I'll allow some time for question and answer here. So key benefits of these roadmaps. Number one, will not impact existing user experience. As mentioned, the only thing new will really be that users will see that add roadmap capability from Project Home. It's gonna provide you a cross-functional, meaning your kind of your waterfall teams and then the function of maybe your development agile teams, big picture view of all projects underway, the ones you decide, making that work visible in one place. You can insert the key dates separate from the schedule. You can set the status separate from the schedule. And then the last point is ease of access to those schedules right from the roadmap. So the last thing I'll show is how to refresh and how the flow works, but I'm gonna pause right there and make sure we don't have any questions. Looks like I have one in the Q&A here. So the question is, if the status can be different from what is in the project, can we get information when the project is updated, like tasks or phase is done? So the only information that flows from the project into the roadmap currently is the kind of the start and finish dates of those particular tasks, summary tasks, milestones that you've added. So you're not able, for example, to bring a custom field that has status over into the roadmap. So the roadmap status is completely separate. The only thing it integrates is the dates. So let's look at that date integration. So I'm back to my schedule here. Well, actually, I'm not back to my schedule, but I'll find my schedule easily by going to open details and into the schedule. So what I'm going to do now is open my schedule for edit in Project Online. So I'm going to go up to the project ribbon and choose edit. And let's say that our planning became more complex than we thought. All these ended up taking 50 days instead of the 10 planned. So I'm going to go ahead and publish this. So that's published and closed. And when I go back to my roadmap now, notice that this is the original completion in February that we had, but this needs to get updated. So there's a couple different ways you can update it. One of those ways would be right over here, once you go to the details view, you see when it was last updated, and I think from time to time, actually, there'll be a little update button that shows up here, but it's not there now, and that's fine. So this would be one way to update a particular item. The other is to go into what's called Microsoft Flow, and you'll find that similar to the way you found the project home screen right here from the apps menu. I can find Flow. I have it open already. And when I first come into the home of Flow, it looks like this. And if I go to My Flows, I'll actually see that behind the scene, as I've been setting up my roadmap, Microsoft has been building flows, and it specifically built two flows here for Project Liftoff. One of these is to bring the task information from Project Online into the roadmap. The second one is to bring information from the Azure Board project into roadmap. So I know I want to update one of these. I can actually go into this and try to figure out which one it is. Okay, I see this is the one connecting because there's the Azure Boards icon. So it's really the second one here that's going to give me the integration to Project Online. So what I can do now is, of course, I could do something like adjust the schedule or simply just click this Run Now button. So I'm going to click Run Flow. It says it started. I can click here to see the activity. It shows me it's running. If I just wait here a moment, it shouldn't take too long. Refresh. Still running. There it is. It succeeded. By the way, if I go back to this, I can also look at how often it was scheduled. I think it's scheduled about every 5 minutes. But if I go back into my project now, and refresh this screen. My roadmap project. It's slow to refresh here. There we go. Now I see, in fact, I'm going to have to zoom out a little bit, but I see it's significantly stretched my planning phase because of the update in Project Online. So that kind of brings you around full story of how updates are made, again, behind the scenes running that flow integration. So hopefully a lot of new things that you've learned today, just again to go back to our benefits. Maybe you hadn't seen the project home screen yet. Quite likely you haven't been able to see roadmap yet. And then of course I was able to show you Azure DevOps projects, as well as flow running behind the scenes to make those updates. So definitely time now for additional question answer, but I wanna mention that there's different ways you can connect with us. Of course, look on our website. We have really a whole series of weekly webinars coming up, just like the one I was able to give you today. You can get linked in with us, myself, Scott, or Jacques, or PPM Works. Any questions you have following this, you're welcome to send to info@ppmworks.com. And we are happy to work with you. It wouldn't take long, a free roadmap build workshop. So we're able to schedule time, help you get roadmap running in your organization and build your first roadmap. A few new questions I want to address there. Are the flows automatically created or do you have to create them? You might have asked that kind of as I was getting into my demonstration. They're automatically created. So you could do something like adjust the timing of them, but they're automatically created for you. And can you share other business use cases for roadmap if you have any? Yeah, good question. So when I look at this roadmap, we've kind of been talking about the business use case, very functional right now so far, I would say, right? We're talking about bringing information together from two different sources, two different products. But let's talk about other use cases that I would envision. One of them might be in an environment where maybe your key stakeholders for a project want to call out the status, meaning this, they click into this item and they want to say for themselves, is it at risk or is it high risk, whatever. In this case, you might have a group of stakeholders that you don't necessarily want editing the project. You just want to give them the ability to indicate the status here. So that I'd say that's another good use case. Also, if you think about these key dates that you're able to add to your overall roadmap, again, this is providing some functionality for a certain stakeholder that would want to manage dates outside of the project. So that would be another use case. Maybe you have key corporate objectives and you might have several projects underneath those objectives, but you have at the top, the leader of that objective, maybe performing an acquisition, rolling out a new online presence, et cetera. And those leaders could manage these high level key dates without being in the schedule. So I'd say that's kind of where you want to start thinking in terms of use cases outside of what I've shown here today. Good. So I think I've answered the questions. You've been a very attentive audience. I appreciate your time. And as mentioned, anything else, let us know at info@ppmworks. Thank you for your time.